Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello student, welcome back to the Vastech channel. In this presentation, today I will teach TCP connection management. TCP connection management contains three things. One is connection establishment, that is called as three-way handshake. Second one is data transfer. Third one is connection closing. So we will see in this session all those things. So that is called as TCP connection management. So TCP, is a point-to-point protocol. In this slide, we will take client state and server state. Both are in the listen state initially. Client want to establish a connection with the server. So initially, what client will do? It will initially try to send. It will send first a special TCP segment to the server side. This special TCP segment contains no application data, that is means it contains no upper layer data, but one of the flag bit in the header, that is sync bit, is set to 1. For this reason, this is called as a sync segment. In addition to this one, client will randomly select one sequence number and put this number in the sequence field of the header and finally enclose this one with the IP datagram and sent it to the server. That is the first step we'll see here. See, initially it is in the listen state. It will select the sequence number, that is the sequence number, random sequence number X, and it will send a sync message where sync bit is sent, set and sync sequence number is X. After sending this message, it will move from listen state to sync sent state. In the second step, once our server receives this datagram containing TCP sync segment, it will extract that one and it will allocate TCP buffers and variables to the connection, and it will send a special segment. There is also sync segment only. It is called as connection granted segment to the client TCP. While sending, it will send a sequence number, something that sequence number and acknowledgement number also. You will come to know here. You see, after receiving this one, server also set sync bit is equal to 1 and server will select its own sequence number Y, and acknowledgement bit is set to indicate it is the acknowledgement as well as sync. Then acknowledgement number is equal to whatever the sync number sent by the sequence number sent by the client plus 1. Once our client receives this one, it also allocate buffers and other variables for the connection, and it will send a final acknowledgement to the server. While sending final acknowledgement, it will set acknowledgement bit is equal to 1 in the header, and acknowledgement number is nothing but sequence number sent by the server plus 1. That indicates for your sequence, this is acknowledgement. I have received your sequence number. I have received your segment. Here you see sync bit is not set because this final connection may contain sometimes data. So once here it is received by the server, server will move from sync received to established state. Client will also move from sync received to established state. This is called as a three-way handshake in TCP, very important question from the exam point of view. After this data transfer will take place. After this data transfer will take place. So this is very important in the exam. You have to write this one. You have to explain this one. Then other than that, you just see the FSM also. Initially, both are in the closed state. You can see here, initially both are in the closed state. You see here, it is a closed state and our server is in the listen state. Server will move to the listen state when the TCP process started here by creating the socket. Its name given here, welcome socket, something like this. So your closed state, our client will create a socket to send the sync segment. So it will send the sync segment by the socket contains information host name and port, and sync bit is set and sequence number is X. Once our client receives acknowledgement for that, after sending this one, client will be in the sync sent state. Once it receives acknowledgement Y from the server and acknowledgement number is equal to X plus X plus 1, then it will send final acknowledgement for the server's sync, that is the sequence number Y, that is Y plus 1, and it will move to the establishment state. This is client side, you think. And this is server side. Server side is in the listen. When it listens sequence number, sync segment with sequence number X, it will send acknowledgement with the sequence number Y, and acknowledgement number is X plus 1, and it will move to the sync reserved state. And finally, when it receives acknowledgement from our client, it will move into the establishment state. So this is the three-way handshake FSM for our the TCP. So how the TCP will close the connection, that is very important. So for closing connection, we know in TCP header, we have seen there are five flag bits are there. One is sync bit, one is acknowledgement bit, one is a push bit, other one is a reset bit, other one is a finish bit. So finish bit should be one. So how things will take place, you see, first client wants to terminate the connection or close the connection. Client will send, here client socket is created. With close connection, it will send a finish bit one, that is finish bit is set with sequence number X. For that, and it will wait here. It will wait. During this time, it can only receive data. After sending segment with finish bit, it will not send any other data. It will just want to receive data because some data are on the way to the client side. So now, after receiving this one, our server will. So our server will send acknowledgement bit one for this finish segment. It will send acknowledgement with the acknowledgement number is nothing but X plus one. Server still can send the data. It has just only sent the acknowledgement for the finish segment, that saying that it has received the finish segment with the finish bit 1 from client. For that it is the acknowledgement. Now server has to send the segment with finish bit. Now our client, as soon as receiving this one acknowledgement, client will move from finwait_1 to finwait_2. Now server will send, because server here is, it has got some data to send, still some data, so it will not send immediately segment with finish bit 1. Once it complete all the sending data, it will send finish bit 1 with the sequence number Y. Now server cannot send any data, but it can receive the data. It cannot send, no longer send data. Finish bit 1 with the sequence number Y. After receiving this one, now our client will move to timed wait state. And it will acknowledge for that one with the sequence number Y plus 1. And timed wait state is equal to 2 into maximum segment lifetime. So with this connection will be terminated. So this is very important, how TCP closing a connection. Very important. Now both will move into the closed state. So this is very important. Now we'll see some scenarios in TCP, retransmission scenarios. So you see host A and host B. Now I will not tell about sequence numbers and all. I hope you understood this one. Here sequence number is 92 and 8 bytes of data it is sending. 8 bytes of data it is sending. Then this one is our host B will send acknowledgement. That is 92 and 8 bytes. Because you know in sequence numbers are allocated. TCP is a byte oriented protocol, right? Numbers are allocated for this bytes. Sequence numbers are allocated for the bytes, not for the segments. So anyway, if you take this particular segment as a number 92, after adding 8 bytes, then it is 100. That means our host B says acknowledgement 100. I have received 92, send me 100. I have received 92 to 99, send me 100. Now this is lost. Here timeout occurs. It will send resend once again. When it resend once again, our host B will come to know it is a duplicate and it will once again send the acknowledgement saying that I have received already, send me 100. So this is the lost acknowledgement scenario. You take this one now. This is called a premature timeout. What is premature timeout? Sequence number 92 is sent 8 bytes. Sequence number 110 send 20 bytes. For that acknowledgement is sent, but acknowledgement is received later. Acknowledgement is received by the client after timeout occurs for the 92. That means it will resend 92 once again. When it resends 92 once again, 92 with the 8 bytes, this is a duplicate packet because it has already received 92 also, 100 also. It will send acknowledgement, acknowledgement 120. This is a cumulative acknowledgement. See, for 92, it will not send acknowledgement 100. It is a cumulative acknowledgement. It want to tell the sender that I have received 120 also, not only 92, I have received 100 also. 100 to 119, send me 120 now. That is the meaning of this one. Third one is cumulative acknowledgement. Once again, here also same thing. 92 is sent, 100 is sent. Acknowledgement is lost. And acknowledgement is lost. Here timeout has not occurred. He sends acknowledgement 120 because he has received 120 also. 119. He will send acknowledgement 120. Now our host A came to know that 120 is also received one till 199 is received, 119 is received by host B. So he will not wait for timeout. He will send us sequence number 120. So this is called as cumulative acknowledgement. So TCP acknowledgement generation event at the receiver. TCP receiver action. So this is whatever theory or so far whatever I explained to you, all those are summed up here. So you have to go through it. Sometimes question may be there. TCP acknowledgement generation event at the receiver and the TCP receiver action. Then TCP timeout period often relatively long. Long delay before resending lost packet. So, whenever there is a long delay, then sender will send packets retransmit. That will result in a duplicate acknowledgement. So, here there is one more classification of this one that is called the TCP fast transmit, retransmit. If the sender receives three acknowledgement for the same data, three duplicate acknowledgement of the same data, then it is an indication that it has received the segment and sender need not to wait for the timeout. It can proceed. That is called as TCP fast retransmit. So that is the meaning of fast retransmit. You can see with the better understand this one with the fast retransmit with this one. You see here 92 with the 8 bytes sent, 100 with the 8 bytes sent, then other packet is sent, etc. So 100 is lost. And for 92 timeout occurs somewhere here. 100 is lost in between. Here is is giving, I mean host B is giving acknowledgement saying transmit 100. 100 is transmitted by the our host A, and our host A is transmitting other packets also, not only 100. You can see here it is not mentioned other than that other packet also. 100 is lost, is giving acknowledgement saying send me 100. That is the first acknowledgement. Then second acknowledgement, once again send me 100, I have not received 100. Third one, send me 100, I have not received 100. So why is not sending 100 here is timeout has not occurred for 92 itself. 100 will come after 92, but once he receives acknowledgement 100, second time, third time, it is a direct indication for the host A, no need to wait for the timeout, send that directly 100. That is called as a fast retransmitter. That is the fast retransmit is transmit after sender receipt of triple duplicate acknowledgement. Fast retransmit after the sender receipt of triple duplicate acknowledgement. This is called as TCP fast retransmitter. So my dear students, with this some important concepts are covered. Now the pending concept is flow control and congestion control. So I will try to post it later, flow control and congestion control. So flow control is also very, very important, how the flow is controlled, what are the different methods. Second one is the congestion control. What do you mean by congestion? What is congestion control algorithm? How it works? Very, very, very important concept. So I will post it later. Thank you for watching.